CEO Steve Allred offered us a peek behind Liberty's closed doors to better understand Liberty's production process. It all starts over by the loading docks.
So the entire process starts right here. Two times a day, the trucks are delivering all U.S.-made steel, what they call hot rolled P&O steel. P&O stands for pickled in oil.
Safe doors and backs come in as flat sheets. John Wolston Hume winds steel off the roll and threads it through a decoiling machine.
Straightened out to a flat sheet. Then from there we take the coil or the flat sheet and punch it out.
Punch station is just incredible when you think about the amount of pressure it must take to shape.
Now, the flattened and prepped steel enters what engineers call roll forming.
It's a little bit tricky to see what's going on in there, but essentially this machine is taking that flat steel and it's starting to shape the sides of the safe. And you can see what it looks like when it pops out on that far end.
The sheet pops out ready to take shape.
It'll then move over into our wing bender, which will bend the sides of the box up into the box shape.
Liberty Safe strength comes partially from a safe box made only of two pieces of steel.
After we go through the wing bender, where our hand process really starts. It's really important on that process because they're tacking that back on so the robots can understand and know what to weld.
Ah yes, the robot. I name it Libertron.
Robots can give you a really consistent, really perfect weld.
Basically 60% stronger than most safes, and you can see it on our videos.
Ah yes, the videos. Liberty's version of R&D. Like that one time they tried to blow up their safes with dynamite.
We've put dynamite inside our safes. We've dropped 1,000-pound blocks of cement onto our safes. What we're proving is that the structural integrity of a Liberty safe is much more superior than the competitors.
And you guys have fun, too.
Not my favorite thing in the world, but I love the impact that it has to the company. But I hate destroying the products that we build. It proved that they're stronger than even what we did when we designed them.
It takes just a few seconds to complete the single bead weld.
When the robot's done with them, they start to look like safes, right? Now it's time to clean them up a little bit.
Grinders get to work. They clean up the corner welds and any spatter. While they grind away the day, a high-powered laser cuts doors to shape. Now welders attach the safe's front door. They space it just right and lock it into place with heavy-duty welds.
Any good safe deserves a wash, right? Think of this area as the biggest shower you've ever seen. Once they're ready to go, they need to be rinsed off, they get etched with a chemical, and then rinsed a couple of times. Now they're ready to earn their colors.
In here, the paint room, where an eternal march of safes moves down the slowly creeping conveyor.
It is such a cool process to watch, but there's more to this story than what you might see. Let me explain. Those little paint particles, they're actually electrically charged, and the safe is grounded so that when the nozzles spray, all those particles absolutely stick like a magnet.
The safes now, ever so slowly, run through a two-stage oven.
The infrared sets off the gelling process, and then a convection oven's what cures it out over a 30 to 45 minute cycle.
You can literally see the paint get shiny as it starts to melt and gel. Let's sneak next door while the paint takes a little time to cure. Zach Byers gets his hands on each safe.
When was the last time you screwed one of these up?
It happens. So.
Not today.
Not today.
Zach wipes Liberty's logo onto each safe. liberty, not just a name, but a belief among these people.
Yeah, overall, there's a lot of pride that we're made in the USA.
Suppose that's why the American flag decorates the production facility. We find them all over. A simple yet profound gesture.
Every single one of the safes gets one of these little boxes. This is like the recipe sheet. These are the instructions so they know exactly what's going into the individual safe.
A burst, a quick draw.
Ricky Sawyer, fastest glue gun in the West. You know, if I were to try that, it'd just be a hot mess, right?
The more fireboard workers add, the higher the fire rating. Now safe from heat, Liberty adds another layer of protection.
They're getting ready to install these locking bars into the door of the safe. Traditionally, safes were locked with round pins.
But Liberty engineers discovered a better mousetrap of sorts.
This is our latest and greatest. This is patent-pending military-style locking bars. And the difference between these and the round pins is obviously you can see that you have more surface coverage so that it grabs the safe and protects it against a pry attack.
You can get a safe with either a mechanical lock or a push button. Turns out a lot more people now choose digital versus mechanical.
Digital locks have come so far that they're very reliable. In fact, we get comments from people asking, well, in the event of an EMP, is my digital lock still going to work? And they are EMP resistant.
Another piece of the security puzzle goes right along the edge where the safe door meets the body.
There's actually a secret to this stuff. It's called polyisol. And if heat gets to it at 212 degrees, it expands and completely seals off the safe, keeping the smoke and the heat out.
Okay, now Liberty trades steel for an iron, actually a steamer. Veronica Castro Nambo builds doors and safe interiors.
She's one of the best. It's amazing how many staples goes into this process. Hey, Veronica, you want a race?
What we do is staple all the interior that goes inside the safe.
Angelica Perez Cortez leads the interior builders. Liberty's finishing team wraps up the production process. Workers add a handle on the outside and stack in shelves and dividers inside. With a big huff and a bump, the safe rolls to the next station. Now, Tiffany Gurley gets one last chance to check out the work.
I inspect the safes to make sure the quality's good, flaws in the paint, flaws in the box itself. The lock works, the mechanism works.
Tiffany knows exactly what to look for. She's been around a while.
22 years.
When you're done with them, they are literally complete.
Forklifts constantly move product around the facility. Most going out first go into this spot, Liberty's most grand warehouse.
People also want a high level of security, and now they get it with Liberty. We'll see you next week.